Okay, we're going to get started. If you can make your way back to your seats, please.
Can I ask a question?
I need to bring it back in from executive session. It is 9:51. We're back from executive session. Ms. Winger, do you have a question?
I do. Pastor Gordon, what is the building currently being used for?
The building has not been used since we purchased it on February 14th. We can't use it.
Well, don't you have missionaries living there?
No.
Are you going to have missionaries living there?
The property is not covered by the SUP, so it's not permitted to be used.
I'm sorry?
The property is not yet covered by the SUP. That's the subject of this application, so it
can't. Oh, so you don't have an SUP?
Not for this new property, no, ma'am. That's the subject of the application.
All of the other 10 properties are covered by the ordinance 1069, which was granted in 2011. In 2013, that ordinance was amended by ordinance 1111, at which time three additional properties were added: tract 2A, tract 3A, tract 4A. This request is to add the property, which is located at 113 Ivywood, that was purchased in February of this year, to amend the SUP to add this property. We have not been using that property because of the fact that we don't have an SUP.
But you can use it for residential use.
We are not seeking to use it for residential use. If you look at our original application, the request is to use the property for church / religious purposes, which is what we filed in 2011, or were granted in 2011 on the other 10 properties.
Well, I just don't understand, you know, what you're saying, because basically what you're telling me is that you can just keep buying properties and can be applying for SUPs and nothing can stop you. That's what I'm hearing.
Well, and that's not what I said to your original question before the executive session, because you raised the question, what's next? And I referred back to the disclosure of the conceptual master development plan, which applies only to the properties on Ivywood Circle.
Mr. Gregory, you had a question?
I find it very interesting. You said church / religious. Why? Why did you separate the two?
I think that was just the phrase that he used. There's nothing significant to that.
Well,
church is religious.
But here's the difference. Relippo looks at religious use. The church, let's say the church wanted to put, as I say, a car lot there. That's church use. That's not religious use. So we're agreeing to church / religious use. I don't mind religious use because that's reasonable and certain. But church / religious use gives the church a real hole they can drive a truck through.
No, sir, that's not the intent. If you look at the application, it says for religious uses, consistent with the other properties.
Okay, let me look.
Councilman Gregory, if I could also clarify that if you look back on the SUP that was granted back in 2011, that too, the request is the exact same request. And as we've been asked previously, is there any difference in this property? And the answer is no. And we were also asked, is the use of this property going to be any different? And the answer is no.
I want to let council in on something because you all weren't there. It had to have been 10 years ago, 12 years ago, I went over and talked with you all privately, of which the council slapped me down because I did it independently. And they volunteered to basically agree to a standstill agreement to not go beyond basically the boundary that they have adhered to, ever, even though they didn't have to. And they did that in good faith, and as I say, Marcy Arbor was livid that I did it. But I think it did show that you had good faith in what you were wanting to do. And I'll just leave it at that. I can only deal with what you have done and what you are doing. But I think the council needed to know that a little bit about whether they act in good faith. And I think so far, I don't think they've done anything to mislead us. Other churches might. I don't think you have.
Thank you, Mr. Gregory. Mr. Fletcher, it's...
Mr. Mayor, can I make a comment?
Yes, sir, Pastor.
I would like to address a statement by Councilwoman Winger earlier about numerous violations. And we...
No, I didn't say violations. Winger. Complaints. Complaints. I didn't say violations.
We have never received notice from the city that there is a complaint about how we are exercising the use of our SUP. Never.
Thank you, Pastor. Mr. Fletcher, can you give us the legal recommendation for council?
I think the council can approve the special use permit. A church use is permitted in the A district. There are reasons why, under the current circumstances, the permit should be approved. In addition, there is a definition in the SUP for church and religious purposes, which means the use of properties and structures as a place of worship, such as religious education, religious meetings, religious instruction, and religious gatherings. It does not include the use for the sale of goods and services, sale of food and beverage, secular social events, athletic events, administrative and office services, or preschool, kindergarten, elementary, and secondary schooling.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher. Do we have a motion?
I move we approve the application for the SUP.
I'll second that.
So we have first by Mr. McCormick, second by Ms. Winger.
No, Mrs. McClellan.
I'm sorry, Ms. McClellan. Sorry, didn't mean to put words in your mouth. All in favor? All opposed?
I'm abstaining.
Abstaining, okay, so it's 3-1-1 with Ms. Winger abstaining and Mr. Sanderson dissenting. And if I'm correct, Mr. Fletcher, you can clarify this, but it doesn't overturn zoning's recommendation. Okay.
I move that we table the rest of our of the agenda here. Most of these items are things that can be taken up by the next council, which will be elected in November.
Okay, if I remember correctly, we can't table the whole thing. We have to go through each one, Mr. Fletcher.
I object to tabling anything. I think we need to finish our agenda. It's only 10 o'clock. We've stayed to midnight plenty of times.
Mayor, specifically on some items like the next one, to advertise for bids, it's just moving forward for advertising bids. We have the submission of the CCPD and the elections contract that has to be done all tonight.
Okay.
I'll modify that, except for those two items right there. Move that we go ahead and table
those. Mr. Mayor,
give me 1 second, Ms. McClellan. Mr. Sanderson, I believe we have to go through each one. I understand your frame of thought, and I appreciate it. Ms. McClellan, yes, ma'am.
I had a question for Mr. Fletcher. When we came back from executive session, were we not supposed to say that no actions were taken?
Yes, that's implied.
Okay.
No actions were taken, just to clarify. Okay, let's see. We are on number 10. Discussion and possible action authorizing the city manager to advertise bids for reconstruction of Banyan Drive and Glen Tower drainage improvements under Watershed 3, Phase 2 and 3. Mr. Rapley.
Yes, Mayor, I'll be quick. This is just to authorize to go out for bids. This has been in the pipeline ever since Councilman Gregory brought it forward back in January. The engineering is almost 100%. In the packet, we had a map and rendering of what the project would look like for the base, and then there's two additional add one and add twos. Council can decide those, obviously, when the bids come in, and the hope is that we can get these bids on the next council meeting.
So, Mr. Rapley, just to confirm, this does not bind the city to anything, but it allows you to get the prices so we can potentially move forward.
Just as we did with Antler back in April.
Perfect. Thank you, Mr. Rapley.
So moved.
We have a motion by Ms. Winger, second by Mr. McCormick.
I do have a comment.
Yes, ma'am.
Really? I'm fully in favor of this particular item. However, I just want it out there one more time that I would love for us to continue to work with San Antonio regarding the detention pond or the basin that's on the other side of Lock Hill Selma off of Carrollwood, that a detention pond or a detention basin is used to control flood flow, and the purpose is to store and slow water. And that area would be a very inexpensive fix, just like fixing the drainage behind HEB, to help with this project, because it's the water that goes to Banyan and Glen Tower, and so that water is of a big concern to me related to this project.
I don't think that's on the agenda.
Okay.
Well, Mayor, real quick, it's noted, Councilwoman McClain, still in discussions with San Antonio on a couple projects right now. But at the end of the day, the Banyan Glen Tower project, at least the base bid right now, is programmed into the 2020 approved budget.
Thank you so much. We have no other discussion. I'll take a vote. All in favor? I'm sorry, Mr. Elzinga. I know, yes. Well, we had some people that signed up to speak, and that's a new luxury now, so let you exercise that. We'll go on the honor system.
Doug Elzinga, 103 Tamworth, and I just want to thank you for considering this. You know, I live on Banyan, and one of the issues, every time it rains, we know it's a river, and really have a health and safety concern every time that it rains. Cars go through there, try to make it through. We almost had someone drown there in 2014. I see kids riding their bikes through that river, acting like it's fun, and someday someone's going to get hurt, someone's going to die. We need to get it fixed. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Do we have anybody else?
I was signed up, but my concerns are already addressed by council member and Bishop.
Thank you, Ms. Scott. Do we have any discussion? All in favor? Unanimous. Thank you, council. Okay, item number 11, discussion and possible action, ordinance number 2019-10-08, an ordinance by the City Council of the City of Castle Hills, authorizing the city to enter into a contract for election services with Bexar County Election Administrator for the November 5th, 2019 special election.
I so move the motion.
So moved. First by Mr. Gregory, second by Mr. McCormick. Any discussion? All in favor? All opposed?
Abstain.
Abstentions? Okay, so it passes 3-0-2 with Mr. Sanderson and Ms. Winger abstaining. Number 12, discussion and possible action, ordinance number 2019-10-08-A, an ordinance by the City Council of the City of Castle Hills, Texas, amending chapter section 44-178 of the Code of Ordinances to prohibit parking on certain streets from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. during school days of the Northeast Independent School District, and adopting a new section of 44-179 of the Code of Ordinances to prohibit parking on certain streets from 7 a.m. to 5 a.m. during school days of the Northeast Independent School District, authorizing issuance of permits for parking used by residents and guests of residents of certain streets affected by the prohibited parking prohibitions of section 44-178 and 44-179. I'd like to add that I've had several residents reach out to me about this, and I have had an opportunity to go out and see the issues firsthand. And I agree that it's something that needs to be done, which is why Mr. Rapley has put it on the agenda.
Excuse me.
So move the motion.
So moved by Mr. Gregory, second by Mr. Sanderson.
But I would like to say that this is actually my item. I brought it up in May and in June, and it should be under my name.
Okay, well,
Mayor, just real quick.
Mr. Rapley.
I've received the complaints that you had obviously provided me and the issue we have there. Late August, I've already had discussions with NISD administration and the lead principal about this, and they've been trying to advocate to students not to park there. But again, I think we're just taking the next steps to enforce here by adding these streets already in the ordinance to amend.
Okay. Do we have a discussion?
Ms.
Winger, can you turn your microphone on?
Yes, I have the microphone on. And I would like to say that I had asked for this, and what we decided was that we were going to do exactly this, but we were waiting for the school year to start, which started in August, and here we are just passing it now. So we're a little late, but it is exactly the item that I brought up in May and June.
So, Ms. Winger, I'd just like...
Ms. Winger, I spoke to the principal in NISD before school started.
Mr. Rapley, thank you. So we've already done a section. This is adding additional streets, if my memory is serving me correctly. So your item has been taken care of, Ms. Winger.
Yes,
this is additional. Chief Siemens, please proceed.
I was trying to expedite questions in case any council had any. So I'll stand down for now.
My two cents on this issue, that this is not going to fix the problem. This is going to push the problem farther into the neighborhoods. So in another 6 months or a year, we're going to have the next block, 100 block of different streets that are going to come back and ask to have no parking signs. There is a huge problem at Lee High School for parking for both staff and students, and this is something that we should be working with the school district to try to come up with a long-term solution that is not just no parking signs. It will temporarily fix the problem for the people that are near the no parking signs, but it is not going to fix the problem.
Why can't we do both?
What was that, Mr. McCormick?
Why can't we do both? Why can't we go ahead and pass the no parking ordinance on Shalimar and Cotillion and proceed to work with the school district to try to work on a long-term solution? I think Ms. McClellan's probably correct, but I don't think that's before us now because it's not on the agenda. I think what we need to do is to go ahead and pass this and then go ahead and work with the school district separately, and I'll leave that to Mr. Rapley to decide how best to handle.
That's starting to sound like a separate agenda item.
Okay, well,
I'd like to mention that Mr. Crow, the principal, has reminded students they actually have shuttle parking, but the students are not opting, which helps alleviate that problem if the students were parking at the shuttle locations, and they are currently not doing that.
And?
Ms. Winger?
And in fact, the reason that they're parking where they're parking is so that they don't have to walk very far. So if we do post it, they haven't moved up the street. What they've done is, to a certain degree, they've moved down to the next street where they can still have a short walk. And as long as the Northeast School District does not build a parking garage, which is unlikely that they're going to do, we're going to continue to have the problem. But it does solve the problem for the people who live there, and it has.
Okay, all in favor? I'm sorry, I get too excited.
She had people that wanted to talk.
Yeah, I know. Ms. Scott?
No, not too far. Meretta Scott, 207 Prince Drive. My question is, I wasn't clear in here, Mr. Rapley, on exactly what sort of stickers or permits are going on cars for residents to be able to park there.
I'd assume it's the decals that we use for the Castle Hills.
So if you have a Castle Hills parking, like the little CH on your car, mm-hmm. and you're parked properly, not blocking a driveway or a mailbox or anything along there, even though it says no parking during that time, you will not be ticketed or towed. Is that
I would assume so. I mean, it's a discretion. It's a time period.
So if they pass this regulation and you're a resident of Castle Hills and you have your Castle Hills sticker, you can still park there even though it says no parking 8 to 5 because you're a resident of the city. That's what this ordinance is saying if it's passed, yes or no? Mr. Rapley.
This ordinance was already passed. We're just amending those streets. It's already in place.
Okay, I just want to know how the citizens can use the streets to park there. Is that that's the sticker they use?
I would assume that would be the one they use. Again, this is from 7 to 5, so if there's an overflow parking by the resident, I would think they can at least notify dispatch that an officer may not provide them any citation. Because if the chief can speak to that, the people actually call in and say, hey, I'm parking on the street overnight, or I'm parking in the street right now. That's kind of the leeway that's given by the officer when he goes out there, if they call it a dispatch.
Okay, so it would have to be a resident of the home they're parking in front of, or the resident's guest, not any citizen.
It says we're going to issue permits.
Yeah.
It says that right here. We're going to issue permits. So people don't have to call in. They have a permit in their car. Just like you have a disabled plaque or any other kind of permit, we're issuing permits. They will have a permit in their car. They can park on the street.
Okay, thank you.
Do we have any other citizens to speak? All in favor?
We already voted on it.
Oh, just for good measure. All in favor? Unanimous. Thank you so much, Council.
Mayor, I would ask if you could take up item 14 first, because that has a timeline in regards to the CCPD adopting the budget, because we have to publish the notice correctly, and we need to know the exact date the council meeting will be on in November in order to adopt the CCPD budget at the next council meeting.
I move to go and take up item 14.
Okay.
CCPD is 13.
Second.
So, Mr. Rapley, you want to...
Go ahead, Mayor.
Clarify.
Point of order. Yeah.
To clarify, you want to do item number 14 regarding moving the council meeting date?
If it stays on November 12th, then we can move forward with processing it. If the news is November 19th, I need to know because it affects
notice. What are you saying? I can't hear.
Okay, so we're gonna
affects the notice for publishing the CCPD budget, so I need to know the exact date of the November meeting so I can appropriately get it posted so we can adopt the budget next month for CCPD.
Okay, we're going to jump into item 14, discussion and possible action on resolution to change the date of the regular November 2019 City Council meeting in the event the special election takes place.
Mr. Mayor.
Give me one second, Mr. Sure. To Tuesday, November 19th, 2019, to accommodate the new council members, Ms. McGlynn.
Mr. Mayor, I object to the consideration of this question. Typically, regular council meetings are set by the adoption of an ordinance, and there's no ordinance proposed for the change of this council meeting.
Mr. Fletcher.
Because it's not going to be a permanent thing as we did with May. It's going to be one time because we don't have special elections every year.
Okay, we're going to hold off and see what Mr. Fletcher has to say about that.
Yeah, it's my understanding that since it's not changing all the council dates, that a resolution may be appropriate.
Okay. Mr. Gregory?
When is Thanksgiving?
Do we have an ordinance?
It's the last Thursday.
It's the following week.
It's the fourth Thursday of the month? Or the third Thursday of the month.
Tuesday.
I'm asking Thanksgiving. When is Thanksgiving?
Oh, I don't know.
That'd be the 28th, yeah.
It's not right
following
then.
Following week.
Subsequently.
Following.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, ma'am.
We're not
I'd
even
like to move
Ms.
to
McGlynn,
approve.
Ms. Winger, Ms. McGlynn had the floor.
We have to have a motion. I'm moving to
well,
approve.
McGlynn
no,
was
I have
talking,
an objection
Ms.
to
Winger.
Consideration on the floor. We haven't even voted on that. There's not even a resolution here proposed to change the meeting, so there is nothing literally for us to adopt
well,
on this matter.
That's unfortunate, but that's what the city attorney is supposed to do and what the city attorney has always done in the past. So if the city attorney can't do his job, that's not my problem, but we can have a resolution nonetheless.
Mr. Fletcher, is there a problem with the way that it's presented? Yes, sir.
Exactly the same resolution as we have for May,
point
so it's not very difficult.
Yes, ma'am, Ms. McLennan.
Actually, May was changed by ordinance.
May is permanent. Why would we have an ordinance to change it for one time? That's exactly what I was advised, to do it by resolution. Why there's no resolution, I don't know. But it's exactly the same wording.
Mr. Gregory.
Election day is the 5th, right? And you can't, Tuesday the 5th. You can't swear in anybody until when? Isn't there a period of which you...
10 days.
You cannot swear into anybody for 10 days. Is that correct?
No. It's 3 days after the election.
Three days after the election.
It's not. Not 3 days at all.
What is this?
Point of order.
What is the law?
Ms. McLennan, can you state your point of order?
Yes, everyone's talking and everybody's talking over each other.
Mr. Gregory.
I just want to know if you have the election on Tuesday the 5th.
I checked with the elections department.
Ms. Winger, can you use your microphone, please?
Is there a period of time that's blacked out of which the newly elected officers can't serve? And if so, what is that period?
Mr. Fletcher?
Ms. Craig, do you know the time frame? You have to hold the button down.
Yes, sir, I do. Cannot be sworn in before 3 days and cannot be sworn in after 10.
I see, so. So they can be sworn in from the 9th, Saturday the 9th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Where did you get the 3 days from? That's not what the Department of Election says.
That's my understanding what it's been for at least the last 40 years.
Well, I don't know, but that's not what the law says.
Ms. Winger, if you're going to ask her a question, I'd ask that you let her answer it.
Well, we've got a city attorney here. He'll tell us the law.
Would you like me to go get a copy of it?
If you don't mind, please. Thank you so much.
3 days. They changed it, but I don't know. They told me it was longer.
As best I can tell, the city code adopted an ordinance that calls for regular meetings to be held on the second and fourth Tuesday of each month.
No, just the second.
I'm reading the code from Muni Code. So it indicates the second and fourth Tuesday of each month at 6:30 unless set for another time or date by the city council.
We changed it to only the second Tuesday, but for May, we changed it to the third Tuesday to allow for the new council that's elected every May to be participating in the May meeting.
And Mr. McCormick?
It seems to me unquestioned that the council has the authority to change the date on the May meeting if they choose to, whether it's done in the form of a resolution or an ordinance for one single meeting. I think matters not in the least as to what we do in the vote. I think we can take the vote, and if we have to have an ordinance, then we can say that it's an ordinance, and if we have to have a resolution, we can do that. But otherwise, we're just wasting time here.
Well, the reason we're not wasting time is because if we have a resolution, it's a regular meeting. And if we don't, it's not.
Ms. Winger, can you clarify that again? I'm sorry.
Okay.
Ms. Winger, can you clarify that again?
Yes. If we don't have a resolution and we don't change it for this one time only, which is an unusual circumstance, then the meeting in November will not be a regular meeting.
Then
so
I'll
to make it a regular meeting, we have to have a resolution.
Then I make a motion that we pass a resolution to change the meeting date for the regular meeting in May to
point of order,
meet in November.
The objection to consideration is still on the table. We haven't voted on that.
Okay, so we have Ms. McLennan's objection.
Okay.
All in favor?
What are we voting on?
Ms. McLennan, can you restate your objection?
I objected to the consideration of this matter because our regular council meetings are typically adopted by ordinance. There is nothing in here that indicates it's just for the one meeting, and
yes,
there is no ordinance to support the change.
Thank you, Ms. McLennan.
Exactly.
All in favor of Ms. McLennan's objection? All opposed? Abstain, Mr. McCormick?
I'm abstaining.
Okay, so a motion, the objection fails by three.
I'd like to make a motion to end debate and actually vote on this item.
Okay, we have a motion to vote. Call, is it a call for a vote?
What's the motion?
Are you calling for a vote?
I am calling for a vote, yes.
There's no motion.
Vote the date of the meeting.
There has to be a motion stated.
I think Mr. McCormick made a motion, I think.
Did you finish that motion?
I started to make a motion, but I was
interrupted. So if somebody wants to make a motion, we can vote on it.
I'll make the motion. I move that we pass a resolution to change the meeting date in November from the second Tuesday to the third Tuesday of the month.
I second.
We have a second. Any discussion? All in favor? All opposed? Okay, motion passes.
And I'd like to see us go ahead with item 13, since all we have to do is get the thing submitted.
Yes, sir. Okay, we're going to backtrack. Submission of the Crime Control Prevention District's adopted 2020 budget to City Council for review and schedule a public hearing. Chief Siemens.
I'm just here for questions again, to expedite any questions. Good evening, staff, city employees, citizens. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. First of all, as you know, we went through quite an ordeal last year to make sure that everybody on the CCPD knew what the rules were and that they were to be followed.
Yes, ma'am.
We also went ahead and appointed new members to the CCPD, but you did not have the budget for those new members. I would like you to schedule a meeting with the new members to approve the budget before we see it, and also
yes, ma'am,
make sure that they vote for officers, which I understand they failed to do, which they have to do every year in September.
Mr. Rapley, you have something to say?
I was going to say, we have the statute that has to have us adopt the budget, the CCPD budget. The new members, I think, were invited to the meeting and didn't attend.
Well, they weren't members yet. The meeting was before
That's
the September
right.
1st assignment.
But so they should be approving this new budget before it comes
Several
to us.
Refused to come, and others are refused to take their seat.
So again,
they weren't going to vote. That's the whole problem. You had it in August, and they weren't members yet. You should have waited until after the September 1st.
I followed the same dates we followed the last
well,
6 years that I've
that
been here, ma'am.
That was a mistake,
no.
And we clarified that last year. So please have a meeting and have the new members there. Okay?
So again, that happened before September 1st, before the new members
that's
took
right.
their positions.
That's
and again,
right.
we're up against a statute that has
that's
to have
right.
the adoption of the budget in a certain time.
They could have met after September 1st.
This original agenda item was on September 17th that we didn't have that meeting, which we would be approving the CCPD budget tonight. This doesn't allow us to push it any further
That's right.
to get this budget
Mr.
adopted.
Rapley,
further, the sitting committee members voted
the
for the dates.
It doesn't
Winger.
Change the fact.
Further, the current sitting members that were appointed by this council voted for the dates in February of this year. I didn't pick the dates. They were consistent with years past, and they voted on them.
Thank you. Mr. Gregory, you had a comment?
Yes, I do. Why are we spending, why do you want to spend $2,000 for SWAT training?
Well, primarily it's for shields and ammunition. It's just mistitled. We've used it for ammunition and other training, alert training, active shooter training, the training that's more applicable now. We haven't changed the title because, frankly, it hadn't come up, but that line item could be retitled to training or civilian response to active shooter training or active.
Well, I'm glad to see because your predecessor was think much of SWAT training.
Well, we used to have a SWAT team, and I'm SWAT certified as well. I was a SWAT team lead at one point, but we've disbanded the SWAT team so that line item is just misnomer.
And what are the community projects that require $5,000 for community programs?
Crime control, led by Council Member McCormick last year, suggested that we increase that last year, which we decreased. I believe it was SWAT or another line item, so there was no change in the budget as a whole. It just, we transferred some funds to that line item to increase some of the community efforts, whether it be the mayor's events that we used to have, National Night Out, Fiesta, just so we can do more things of that magnitude.
Can't go to Fiesta.
Sir?
It can't be used by Fiesta.
No, not for Fiesta itself, but for things that we would do in preparation or after, any other events throughout the year, whether it be a back to school, or just other events, community events that Councilman McCormick thought made a recommendation and crime control supported and voted for it.
I'll agree to this, but I would appreciate if you would present to me what you spent the money last year.
Yes, sir. I'm quite positive it was mostly National Night Out stuff, but I can get that to you, Councilman.
Mr. Fletcher, you had a comment?
Yes. I think I'm going to ask that one of the council members make a motion to reconsider item 14 as looking at the election calendar. The last day for conducting the official canvass of the election is the 11th day after the election, which is the November 16th and extended to November 18th.
That's when we have the canvass. That's right. So then we have the canvass, but that's not the regular meeting. We do that every year.
Mr. Fletcher, you don't want it done on the 15th because...
Hold on. Wait. Let's finish the current agenda item, and then we can go back. Okay.
Well, I think part of the current agenda item is in reliance on the previous agenda item.
Okay, so this one needs to die out so that we can go back. And
has there been a motion?
There's no motion, so...
I would just ask there be a motion to reconsider item...
And explain.
15, excuse me.
Why? Why again? Oh,
before we can get into that, we have to go and we have somebody have to make the motion.
For what?
Let's finish one item at a time. Can we get finished with getting the crime control budget submitted?
Mr. McCormick, I think the issue is that the crime control budget is contingent on number 14. So we have to, if there is an issue, which there obviously is, with number 14 on the date that we have the next meeting, we have to take care of that before we can take care of 13, since we do not have a motion.
As I understood what Ms. Winger said, we can have a special meeting to canvass the vote pretty quickly after the election, right?
You can have a special, you can set up a special meeting and hopefully there's a quorum.
I'm not planning on being here. Are you going to do that? Are you going to have a special meeting?
Am I?
Well, I'll be here if I have to be, but I don't really want to do it.
I first don't understand what it is in the crime control prevention district budget that is tied to the previous motion.
Because I need to know the exact date so I can put the notice to publish the public hearing in time to have the adoption next month at the council meeting. It's the same thing we did last year where we put a notice on the October meeting and we adopted the CCPD budget in November of last year.
So what's the problem?
I need to know the exact date of next month's council meeting.
We just said the exact date. It's November 19th.
Well, Ms. Winger... Mr. Fletcher obviously found something different, and that's why he would like for us to bring the item back.
Mr. Fletcher's concern is that the canvass has to take place within 11 days following the election.
Right.
Correct.
We can do that by special meeting.
And have another meeting on the 19th.
Right. And have another meeting on the 19th.
The regular meeting will be on the 19th, and the canvass will be on the 11th. Is that what you're saying?
It just has
to be.
Well,
11 days after.
It has to be before the 18th.
Sorry?
Canvas needs to be done before November 18th.
Okay.
November 19th or November
18th?
Okay, well, that's fine. But the canvas is something separate. That's when people are sworn in, but that doesn't mean that they can sit.
I just wanted to bring that to your attention. You had asked about the specific dates. We brought the calendar.
Okay, so you want a special meeting to canvas and to consider and to have a public hearing on the CCPD budget? Is that what you're asking?
Go ahead, Ms. Craig.
They cannot take the oath and act as a council person till after the canvass. The canvass has to be between the 8th and the 18th.
Right. So then they can, in theory, sit for the 19th.
Okay, so we'll have to have a special meeting to canvass, in which case we can proceed with the next meeting on the third Tuesday.
So assuming you all call a special meeting for the canvass, then disregard my motion to reconsider request.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so digressing to item number 13, do we have a motion?
No, he's on 13. He's the crime control.
No, 13.
Oh, yes.
Mr. Rapley, for number 13, do we just need to make a motion to schedule the public hearing?
Just schedule the public hearing so I can put the notice out.
I move that we schedule the public hearing for Tuesday, November 19th, 2019.
Second. We have a motion. We have a second by Mr. Gregory. All in favor? All opposed?
So we're doing it on the same day as the meeting, in other words. Is that okay? I mean, I thought there was a problem.
No.
So, Ms. Winger, how do you vote?
Oh, so you're going to canvass and you're going to do everything?
No, ma'am.
I just understand. Did you say there was an issue with when we can when we have to have this public hearing?
You have to canvass by before the 18th, and if I'm not mistaken, the 18th, is that a Monday?
It's a Monday.
So you're looking at canvassing before the 18th.
Okay,
right.
So we can do that. But
yes,
that's a separate meeting.
That's what we're doing right now.
Okay.
But we voted for that.
Oh,
so did
we're
you vote in favor?
So we're not voting on 13. We're voting on a separate item.
No, we're voting on 13. We just voted on it. You're the only one that hasn't voted. How do you vote?
I'm sorry?
We just voted on item number 13. How do you vote?
This is a crime control.
I already voted to on item 13. We're moving it to what? I don't know what date we're moving it to.
Well, since the meeting's already been set, Ms. Winger, it's going to be on the same
day.
Okay,
so she just said November 19th.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so are we going to canvass on that date as well?
Ms. Winger, that's not
on
this agenda item.
Okay. So we're only setting this for the hearing is going to be the same date as the regular meeting.
That's correct.
Fine.
How do you vote?
Yes.
You vote? Okay, perfect. Unanimous. Motion to adjourn.
This time sensitive item on number
I second.
14, or the last item is time sensitive.
Okay.
Which item?
So, Mr. Fletcher, do we have to go through and...
Uh-oh.
Sorry, Mr. Paul, I already passed. I apologize.
Well, we had a motion.
Sorry.
So we have a...
Let him speak. If he wants to speak, I think we should let him speak.
By all means.
It's very simple. Number 14. I'm confused, and if you would, maybe you could ask the audience.
This is out of order, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, Mr. Paul, we have to take a vote to hear from you. Who would like to hear from Mr. Paul? Who would not like to hear from Mr. Paul? Okay, so I guess we'll hear from you.
Good, thank you. Frank Paul, 112 Shalimar. Mr. Mayor, if you would you ask the authors of item 14, Ms. Winger and Mr. Sanderson, what they mean in the event of the special election, if it takes place? I don't understand the language because it's already set. I see they didn't vote for number 11, so I don't know what they mean by that. Maybe you can ask them to explain what they mean by in the event it takes place, because I thought it's already set in stone. And anyway, thank you. That's my question.
Thank you so much. We have a motion to adjourn. Mr. Fletcher.
Item on the last one.
Okay, so...
19.
Discussion on the status of lawsuit styled Sylvia Gonzalez ETL versus City of Castle Hills, cause number 2019-CI-14595, and possible action. Mr. Fletcher.
What item is this?
This is number 18.
18? I don't have an item 18.
Okay, so.
Well, it looks as though.
It's not in my packet.
Council member is leaving, so it doesn't appear as though we'll have a quorum.
Okay, so we've lost our quorum. The meeting is adjourned. It is 10:33. Thank you.